Hey everyone, this is just going to be a short little video on something that I was thinking about. So I'm creating a game in Raylib, and it's going to be a top-down roguelike. And as one of the things that I'm doing for this is I want the weapons in my game to be procedurally generated. Actually, let me just. Oh, wait, no. I thought about this. Right here, I just kind of. The code doesn't matter, so you don't have to pay attention to that at this point in time. But, basically, I labeled the variable wrong, but it doesn't matter because I literally did it for this video. As we can see, it's kind of early goings, but that's not the point. While creating this, I basically created a weapon modifier viewer, and we can see here that it fires, and I have it firing 10 projectiles, and currently I have it on angle of fire mode. Basically, that means that there's 10 degrees between each and every projectile that gets fired out. When I add more projectiles, it adjusts the starting angle and final angle automatically. And then if I go back in and change it, we will see that now it's all in the same because now it's using the total spread. So if I crank this up to, let's say, a 45 degree angle, we still have those 10 projectiles, but it's locked between a 45 degree angle starting at negative 22 and a half. And ending at 22 and a half. I can change this up to 20 and it still be the same. Instead of incrementing itself by what looks to be slightly less than 2.5 degrees when it's 10, it's incrementing, I want to say by half that, but, it's, the same from, it's incrementing probably, from, slightly less than 2.5 to, like, roughly 4 or 5 when it's 10 projectiles. But, like, I can crank this up to, 90. And you know what, I'll probably invent sliders next. 90, and then we can see that it's now locked between 90. The reason I'm making this video is basically the thought process on generative systems and the like. Interesting. But generative systems and the like, and the idea that parameters shouldn't necessarily affect one another. And what I mean by that is, it all started with my thought process of, do I go with the angle of fire approach or the total spread approach? And I'm so sorry about the poor frame rate, by the way. I hope it doesn't affect the audio. But basically, the going with the angle of fire, so in the first one where it's 10 degrees and it automatically adjusted the total spread versus the total spread, and it automatically adjusted the angle of fire. Basically, it's the idea that if I go with the angle of fire, it limits the amount of projectiles that I will actually be able to have per weapon, because I don't want it going from the start, and then let's say the random generator would do, say, and I probably wouldn't have this as the upper limit, but just for the sake of argument, the upper limit ends up being like 360, and it gets a angle of fire of 10. Well, that those projectiles will go around the circle 36 times. So therefore, it's shooting back at you 36 times. It's shooting out 36 times. And let's just say that I don't want any projectiles firing back at the player. It just doesn't seem right. Maybe I want it so that the projectiles can do friendly fire, and like you yourself are friendly. So like, if you do something stupid, like launch a bomb at your feet and walk over the bomb and it explodes, maybe I want that to actually injure the player. So, if that shoots back at you, then it's just a bad weapon. And I don't want a generator that creates bad weapons, as it were. Like, I want some weapons to be worse, I want some weapons to be better, but I don't necessarily want any objectively horrible weapons. Or at least not right now. Maybe in the future I'll be all sadistic and be like, ha ha ha, maybe this weapon actually heals the enemy. And or maybe every time the player fires this, it hurts himself. Maybe I'll get to that point. But as of right now, I don't want that. So that brings us back to total spread. I can lock total spread into being, I can limit that into being 180 or 270, let's say. But I'm only going to click up to 180 because I designed my tools slightly poorly. I spent more time thinking about this than the tools. But now I can limit it, the total spread, to being 180, and it doesn't matter the number of projectiles. I have 50 projectiles. I can have 2 projectiles, and that goes back to the question of definitely bad weapons. Yeah, this isn't gonna fire exactly where you want it to, but it will fire predictively in a manner that you could actually use it. But with the angle of fire, I would not only have to limit the amount of the between, like, oh, the angle of fire has at least 1 degree of difference versus, let's say, an upper limit of 45 or 90 or 180. in order to get the same functionality that we see here. If I have the maximum angle of fire at 180, then I would have to limit the number of projectiles very low at high angles of fire. And as much as I want systems that correlate and have causation, correlation versus causation, anyway, as much as I do want systems that have causation, I shoot a fire projectile at an explosive barrel and causing it to explode, I don't necessarily believe that the side effects is a good word. It's a word that we use in functional programming in order to be like, hey, we don't want this function in order to affect the state of things. Therefore, if it affects the state of things, it has side effects. We don't want our parameters in the generative procedural generation to necessarily have these side effects, or in the very least, I don't with what I'm doing here with this weapon. We don't want my angle of fire to limit the number of projectiles that I have. So that, I mean, that's basically all I had. That was a little tidbit of wisdom that I came up with. This is no doubt going to be a low quality video, but I hope the information that has been provided within counts more than the presentation quality. But thank you all for watching. Subscribe if you want to see more. Peace.